I was going to share some scriptures that prove that Jesus was God, is God, and claimed to be God. Mm-hmm. You said earlier that you don't think he is God.
So my understanding is not that I don't think. It's just my opinion based on what I've, I guess you could say, gotten. Like I've read and my understanding, maybe that's the best way to say, is I feel like he's the son, like the son of all of us. Like in the Bible, from my understanding of the things I've read, we're all the son and daughters of God, right? That's what we were taught.
If we accept Christ.
Yeah, of course. Yeah. But that's, as long as you accept Christ and welcome into your heart and you ask for forgiveness and you try to follow the guidelines, I guess you could say, of certain things, you're not going out there being a really horrible person, you know. But I want to hear, yes.
Yeah, I mean, for those who repent of their sins, I don't really use the ask Jesus in your heart. Because a lot of people say that and they live like devils. And I think Jesus loves them and they live like devils. But yeah, it's more of repenting of your sins, all your sins, and turning to Jesus Christ. But this, here in John chapter 1 says, In the beginning was the Word. And the Word was with God, and the Word was God. And right there in John 1, verse 1. And it says down here in verse 14, and the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. And actually throughout John, Jesus asserts his deity, and that, like he said in, I think, John 8, chapter 8, the end of John chapter 8, he said to the people, truly, truly, I say to you, before Abraham was born, I am. Because he was saying that he said, your father Abraham rejoiced to see my day, and he saw it and was glad. So the Jews said to him, you are not yet 50 years old, and have you seen Abraham? Jesus said to them, truly, truly, I say to you, before Abraham was born, I am. And of course, I am, that's what God said to Moses back in Exodus 3, chapter 3.
Yeah.
Who shall I, like when he, I'm going to go to Pharaoh, who shall I tell him sent me? God said, I am. And so then it says, therefore they picked up stones to throw at him. Now why did they do that? Because they knew he was claiming to be God.
Yeah.
That, and there was other times where, like, when he granted, he told people your sins are forgiven, and then the religious leaders said this fellow blasphemes, because who can forgive sins but God alone?
Mm-hmm.
And Jesus said that the Son of Man has authority on earth to forgive sins.
Yeah.
So he, by that, he was, you know, asserting his deity, that he was and is God. And the fact that he accepted worship. Because when you have, like, you had instances in the Bible where angels refused worship, when like John the disciple tried to bow down to an angel, the angel said, "Don't do that." When Cornelius bowed down to try to worship Peter, Peter said, "Don't do that. I too am just a man." But Jesus never turned anyone away. He never refused worship. So that
that is proof too.
Especially in the Gospel of John, time and time again, like I even have notes in the beginning of John for all this. You're welcome to take a picture if you like. But I actually have both on here and here, all the, not just in John,
scriptures
that assert his deity.
I should. I'm very thankful that you have this, because I've honestly been very curious. I want to figure out what exactly.
Here too.
I'm searching. Oh, here, yeah. I like that you do. My grandma used to do things like this. All of it down here is too. Or some. I'll check it. Oh, the deity I see at the top. Okay.
I'm not sure if these are some of the same ones on the back, but you can see, like, there's a lot of scriptures that prove that Jesus is God, and Or, and like, because they actually tried to murder him, I think 10 times before they put him on the cross.
Actually put him on the cross, yeah.
And it's like, why did they try to do that? Because they knew he was claiming to be God.
Above the Catholic priest, right? Yeah.
And all it wasn't just that he was interrupting their status quo. And he, like today, you interrupt the business of most churches and they're not going to like it. So they responded by murdering him. And that changes everything, because if Jesus is God, then that changes everything. If he wasn't God, that changes everything.
Both, yeah.
Hence the question, who do you say Jesus is? And if he's just a man, then Christians have no hope. Nobody has any hope. If he's God, then what he said is the most important thing. The Bible, that is the most important thing. If he did not rise from the dead, that changes history. And not just his death on the cross, but if he did not rise from the dead, it changes everything. But of course, the tomb is empty, and even the religious leaders recognize that the tomb was empty, and they actually conspired to cover that up.
Yeah.
And
see, that was something that my mom had a big argument with. Is like, how do you prove that somebody disappears? I can bury you right now. And that was always my mom's fight, to be honest. So I never questioned, when your parents are animate about something. And so when I became older, that was my biggest question. What happened to Jesus?
I'm gonna change it.
Can somebody answer that? Not that I'm asking you, but
yeah.
That was my whole point.
That was okay.
21. It was something that I was like, it meant a lot to me. And when Pastor Troy explained it to me the way he did, it was like I how do I say it? It was like that was the match strike, I was just like, I want to read into this. I can't say yet that I have my 100% answer for what actually happened, but my belief is that if he is and was God, or even the Son of God, because that's where I'm in a way confused, but not 150%, confused, is I know in some kind of way, I know that he made the biggest change for all of us who are sinners, who have even lived in sin, turned away from sinner, or I don't know how to word that. I'm horrible with words, but I that is a question that I feel like has moved my spiritual journey per se. It started me wanting to figure out, what do I believe? Do I believe that this is this, or do I believe that? And so that's my question.
It was and is Jesus God?
Yeah. Is, was, how, because that, honestly, coming from a family with no religious background, my grandma, yes, but beforehand, no. My mom and my dad, like I said, my dad will go in nature, and that's his escape and source to feel rejuvenated by God. He'll tell me all these things, and I don't agree. I can't say that I don't 100% agree, because when I go sit in front of the ocean, and when I go sit at the river, I feel good, I really do. I feel like this is where I need to be. I have peace. I have, I have a place where I can free my head of thoughts, and I can just vent, and I can pray, and I can be 100% just open, and I can tell him, God, thank you. That's where I feel safe, where I can 100% just be I don't know how to explain how I feel, but that's my best way to tell you. That's where I felt I get where my dad's coming from, where he says that's where he feels where he can connect with God, and he does pray. I've seen him when my nana passed away and stuff, but that's my question. How do you, what made you, be like, this is what I believe? What exactly guide me so that I know where to look when I go home or something?
God saved me when I was pretty much, coming out of high school. I'd always believed in God. I'd always believed Jesus existed. That was about as far as I went. And I started going to churches for, not good reasons. I just had nothing better to do, honestly. I was invited, and so I started going. I don't know if it really had any difference, made any difference for me, but I started being convicted of my sins. I don't even know why. God started convicting me. And eventually, this is 20-something years ago, 20 years ago. And what I recall is I was convicted about all the stuff I was listening to, my rock and roll, all the garbage on TV, my language, and
that's something that my grandma got on me about was, I have a potty, my niece said that, I have a horrible mouth, and my grandma used to say, young lady, you know, just think about what you're doing, you know, things you're putting out of your mouth. She was like, that's you know, good. You speak things into existence, you do da-da-da-da-da, and da-da-da-da, and I'm like, ah, grandma, you know, but now it's just gone, it makes me wonder, you know, like, and then this is me being honest, my grandma passing is what strikes me now, you know, she just passed two years ago, and I don't know necessarily that I'm okay with me not having the answers I want. You know, I want to know, like, what made her so like, strong belief. You know, I want that. If this is what I'm missing, and I feel drawn to, like, I want to learn. I want to know, like, what is it that I'm supposed to be doing? I don't want to misguide my children, my nieces, my nephews. I don't want that. You know, I tell my husband all the time, you know, let's say his religion is the religion, you know, or I don't know how to word my words. That's why I get frustrated. But, like, I told him, I said, you know, now that I'm reading the Quran while I'm reading my Bible, that's why I'm having a conflict too, is like the very small but large mentally differences in what he believes and what our Bible says is do you know anything about Muslim religion?
What's that?
Do you know anything about Muslim religion?
I know a little bit about it. I studied a little bit into it.
So Pastor Troy and me were talking, and even he says that the thing that makes Muslim religion and us, other than like the obvious covering and things like that, the book part, the Quran puts it that Jesus is a prophet. Why do they believe it? Like, what would be something that even, like,
well,
why would they?
They believe.
Because that's where I get confused.
From my understanding, they believe that he was a prophet and a good teacher, but not God.
Yeah, that's right.
And that changes everything right there.
Yeah.
And so it, like, the question there is, if he was a prophet, if he was a good teacher, but not God, then why did he claim to be God?
Yeah, and he told people, and he didn't even deem that these people were anything. He actually forgave them, and he kept saying. But see, my question, in the Bible where I read, and a few places I cannot quote yet. I pray that one day, that one day I can quote the different things that I've read, where it says that even Jesus on the cross, he says, Father, forgive them for their sins. If he is God, how did he ask himself for, you know what I'm saying?
Well, that's a good question, because I asked when I was brand new to the faith, like,
me too.
Almost 20 years ago, I even asked a friend, how can, I'm not sure how I worded it, but like, how can Jesus be God's son if he's God?
Yeah.
And he's like, well, just as like a human father has a human son or human daughter, right? And so God has a son. They're both God, you know, their nature is God.
They carry on. Okay.
And so you have God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
And the Trinity. And it's one God, three persons. Now the thing is, can any one of us understand that? No. Because we're finite, God's infinite, and it takes humility to realize I don't understand this, but I don't need to.
See, back in the day, if you guys were talking, like, leave me alone, because I couldn't come up to you. And
well,
I don't know what the hell I'm talking about.
It doesn't, like, but that's because in the Bible talks about that in Isaiah 55, that His ways are higher than our ways, and His thoughts than our thoughts. Mm-hmm. God's infinite; we're finite, so there's gonna be things we don't understand.
Yeah,
if we could understand God, that'd make Him like us, right?
Yeah.
But there's, I mean, that's the question, like, who was Jesus? I mean, that's the question for the ages. And he was either, it's been put out this way before, he was either a liar, a lunatic, or he was Lord.
Yeah.
So if he claimed to be God several times.
Yeah.
So if he was a good teacher and a prophet, why did he do that? Why did he accept worship?
Yeah, all
right?
of it. Yeah.
Why did he? Why was he able to forgive sins? If only even the religious leaders recognized that only God can forgive sins, but he did it, and they said this guy blasphemes.
Yeah.